How you doing, guys? It's your girl, Miss Benjamin Buttons 01, and I'm back. Now, this time, I got the strawberry letter. What is wrong with crazy women? What is wrong with them?
On tight. Here it is. Strawberry letter.
Subject of the letter, should I get my man back? Hello, Steve and the morning crew. I have a huge problem. I dated a married man for several months. We had a wonderful time together. We were able to date each other because we are in the military, and he was stationed in the same place as I was, and his wife lived in a different state.
All right.
She is this high-powered executive and refused to relocate for her man because she wouldn't make the same kind of money in a different location. Big mistake. That's where I came in. He was lonely, and I was there. Mm-hmm. We had a wonderful time together and even professed our love for each other. Yes. Everything was great until his wife came into town unexpectedly, and she decided that her man needed to be where she was. My lover put in a request to be transferred to her area, and the military approved it. I tried everything to break their marriage up before he left me. I wrote his wife, sent her pictures of us, confronted her, and tried to fight her, and professed my love for her husband. Still, she remained with my man. He is mine. He told me he loved me, and I believed him. I think his wife used voodoo to get him to be with her. I am thinking of doing the same to get my man back. Wow. I miss him so much. He has been gone for several months now and refuses to accept my calls or emails. He told me to leave him alone, that what we did was a mistake. He and his wife are going to counseling to work on their marriage, and he is happier than he's ever been. I don't believe this. He is only saying this because his wife put him up to it. He told me he was going to leave his wife for me, and I just want to make that happen. He is mine. How could he say he never loved me and we were a mistake? Not my man. He would never say that. My question is, should I use voodoo to get my man back from that crazy woman who took him away? Oh, yeah. I love him and I miss him. Signed, Angry Mistress. Yeah. This is one of those crazy ones. 12 minutes after.
You gonna respond to this
one? I can't, yeah.
Okay, cool.
Come on, stay with your response to part two of today's Strawberry Letter. Let's go.
Should I get my man back? Here's this ignorant letter. Hello, Steve and the morning crew. I have a huge problem. I dated a married man for several months. We had a wonderful time together. We were able to date each other because we are in the military, and he was stationed in the same place I was, and his wife lived in a different state. She's a high-powered executive. He used to locate for her man because she wouldn't make the same kind of money at a different location. Big mistake. That's why I came in. See, he was lonely, and I was there. We had a wonderful time together, and even professed our love for each other. Everything was great until his wife came into town all unexpectedly, and she decided that her man needed to be where she was. My lover put in a request to be transferred to her area, and the military approved it. I tried everything to break their marriage up before he left me. I wrote his wife, sent her pictures of her, confronted her, and tried to fight her and profess my love for her husband. Still, she remained with my man. He is mine. He told me he loved me, and I believed her. I think his wife is going to get back with her. I'm thinking through the same thing to get my man back. I miss him so much. He has been gone for several months now and refused.
Pause. Is it me, or do Steve sound like he is really digging into the retarded side of this woman? He is channeling her inner retarded. I mean, just the way he sounds. Like, he is channeling her inner retarded. And I know retarded is a very... I apologize. Her inner mentally challenged. I apologize. I'm so sorry.
To accept my calls or emails. He told me to leave him alone. That what we did was a mistake. He and his wife are going to counseling to work out their marriage. Say he happier than he ever been. I don't believe that. He's only saying this because his wife put him up to it. He told me that he was going to leave his wife for me. And I just want to make that happen. He is mine. How could he say he never loved me and we were a mistake? Not my man. say that. My question is, should I use voodoo to get my man back from that crazy woman who took him away? I love him and miss him.
That crazy woman? Did she say the wife is the crazy woman? Oh, girl, continue.
Angry mistress.
Dear angry mistress, did you really call his wife a crazy woman? You know what? What the heck does that make you? You are a fatal attraction. Sending his wife pictures, trying
flesh.
To fight her. All of that crazy mess. What do you think was supposed to happen? This is his wife, okay? Everything that you guys had, everything that you guys talked about when you were intimate, all that's over, okay? He told you out of his own mouth after he realized that you were crazy to leave him alone and you guys were a mistake. So why don't you do that? Go away. It's over. Leave this man alone before you end up like Glenn Close in the movie, for real. You know, she ended up, you know what happened to her.
Yes, ended up dead.
Shot in the bathtub. Remember that? Killed.
Dead.
Dead.
You threw,
thank you.
Yeah.
All I want to say is, let's just start anywhere in this letter. Y'all done ready to know.
Crazy.
I tried everything to break their marriage up before he left me. First of all, look, before I do that, she's a high-powered exec. Refused to relocate with her man because she wouldn't make the same kind of money. Big mistake. That's where I came in. See, refer to yourself from now on as that's where I, the home wrecker, came in.
Exactly.
See, always know who you are. Please list yourself in the proper category.
Live know
that
in
you
your
are a home wrecker. Okay, now, let's go home wrecker. You did everything to break their marriage up. See, that's what home wreckers do. You say, I tried everything to break their marriage up. I wrote his wife, sent her pictures of us, confronted her, and even tried to fight her. That's the point I need. How you try to fight somebody without fighting? What happened? What happened when you tried to fight her? Let me tell you how that went. Oh, high-powered exec that you didn't really know came to town. Found out the girl was a little bit thicker than you thought. She was about 5'7", had a thing together, in the gym, nice. She fit, but she nice, though. She had a little Ann Taylor suit on, and it was fitting kind of snug. Had them little crinkles right up under the butt crease. That's when you know the dress is just one size a little bit too tight. But she had them nice calf muscles on her. It made her legs stand up in them pumps and made her look strong. Well, when you ran up on thick things, and you was thinking about fighting them, well, you realized you might get your ass whooped. That's when you said, uh-oh, I can't fight her. This could be the death of me. I saw a woman like this climb over the wall just last week in basic training. Look just like her. You couldn't whoop her. So what made you think you was going to try to fight her? Now let's get down to it. You thinking about using voodoo? Come on. Lady, let's go over some of the voodoo things you might want to try to get your man back. You can hang chickens all around the bedroom if you want to. You can freshly cut their heads off and have their bodies running around and chatting. Hallelujah. You can do whatever you want to do. You can put a pit bull paw in the chicken, son. Try that. I heard that make a man stay. Maybe you can hang your panties on an ostrich neck. While the ostrich is sitting on the egg on the Serengeti.
What?
I heard that can help get your man back.
That one.
Maybe you can suck on a crawfish head while you sipping on pigeon pee. Maybe that'll get your man back. I don't really know too much voodoo myself.
It
I'm just
like
coming
you know.
Out what I think can get you. Maybe you can get on your knees and pray facing the east with an alligator locked on your butt. Try that.
Is that voodoo?
I don't know. I'm just trying to help you. Maybe you can fill up a chitlin box with his teeth in it. I don't know what you're going to do. I'm just trying to come up with some voodoo moves for you. Because guess what? He gone.
Yeah. Thank you, Steve. You know we gotta go. Email or Instagram us your thoughts on today's strawberry letter at my.
On tight. Yep.
Okay. Gotta read it because it's just too damn funny. It's too damn funny. Because I just. First today, the first one, the earlier this evening. Okay. Oh, I got distracted by Okay. All right. I got distracted. I was looking at something on my Instagram page. I have a huge problem. You're right. You know what the problem is? The problem is not should you get him back. The problem is you crazy and you don't know it. And I don't think this man know how crazy you is either. Because if he did... Okay. I have a huge problem. I dated a married man for several months. We had a wonderful time together. No, you had a wonderful time. No, he had a wonderful time. Y'all had a wonderful time, but in two different ways. Let's just put it that way. We were able to date each other because we were in the military and he was stationed in the same place as I was. And his wife lived in a different state. All right. She's a high-powered executive and refused to relocate for her man because she wouldn't make the same money, kind of money in a different location. Big mistake. How is that a big mistake? It was a big mistake. You were stocked. You were stocked. Because you knew this man was married, and instead of you just backing off, you were thought. Say big mistake. That's when I came in. You were sitting around the whole damn time. What do you mean that's when you came in? You were sitting around the whole time. Just sitting around this man here with your skanky butt. Just sitting around. His wife, you watching him and watch her leave and all this, and you just sitting around. He was lovely, and he was lonely. I don't know who is typing this for Shirley. I mean, yeah, Shirley, but she need to get somebody to edit this because it's a lot of grammatical errors on here, but I'm not going to go through that right now. Because it says he was lovely and I was there. He was lonely and I was there. We had a wonderful time together and even professed our love for each other. Do you know what you can make a man say when you giving him the good, good baby? Do you know what you can make a man think you he gon'? Do you know what you are capable of when you got them? When you got that grip on him? Do you know what you capable of doing? You can get the man to say he denounced Jesus when you got the right grip on him. So of course he's gonna tell you he love you. You sucking the soul out of him. What is wrong with you? We professed our love for each other. Everything was great until his wife came into town. What the hell you thought was gonna happen when his wife came to town? Oh, okay. That's what you thought was going to happen. Okay. Unexpectedly, she decided that her man needed to be where she was. My lover put in a request to be transferred to her area, and the army and the military approved.
You sound like you surprised, and the military approved it. What you thought they was gonna deny him? I mean, in some circumstances they probably would, but I don't think this was one of those circumstances, sweetheart. I don't see why you would have thought. I don't understand. I don't get it. Unexpectedly, I tried everything to break their marriage up.
before he left me. I wrote his wife and sent her pictures of us, confronted her, and tried to fight her and profess my love for her. Girl. Because I don't think a grown woman with common sense would have did this. Little girl. What in the hell? You wrote this woman. See.
Excuse me.
Okay, excuse me. Apparently this lady here know you ain't right up here. She know. Cause she ain't following you up with this. Cause you wrote her. Sent her pictures. And y'all confronted her and tried to fight her and professed your love. Do you know the average lady, the average black, if you black, I'm beginning to think this is probably some white people. But this ain't the way this would have went down. This was a black woman and a black one. About a black man. And it wouldn't have went down that way. You wouldn't have said no. You wouldn't have wrote me and sent me no letters and confronted me and tried to. Because once we got to the confronting part. Oh, baby. Taking off his earrings. Tying up all his weave. Here, baby. Oh, we going in. Oh, we getting it in. You going to confront me? Write me? Send me pictures of y'all and profess your love. You love him? Oh, you love him? I'm gonna show you just how much he love you. Watch he gonna haul tail with his wife. His wife. I'm wife. You jump off. You don't mean a thing. Let's see. He's mine. He told me he loved me and I believed him. The video ain't stopped, y'all. I'm just stunned at how stupid she is. God, I hate when they do that. I think his wife used voodoo to get him to be with her. That's his wife, girl. He ain't used no voodoo. Well, not he. She ain't used no voodoo. That's his wife. And 9 times out of 10, she'll make way more money than you do. I think that's why he's sticking with her regardless. She made way more money than he do in the military. That man ain't stupid. Y'all two together, her one check by herself, probably the both of y'all's together. Why he gonna leave his wife? He probably do love the lady. Men, I mean, sometimes it's just something that happens with an indiscretion. Sometimes. I miss him. Oh, I'm thinking about doing the same thing to get my man back. He is not your man. He is not. Lady, girl, that is not your man. That's not your man. That's that woman man. The one that's wearing the ring, that's her man. That's not your man. I didn't understand the title of the letter. Should I get my man back? That's not your man. That's this lady man. The one who you saying is crazy. The one who you say got voodoo on him. That's her man. I don't know. You know what? I don't get these side chicks no more, bro. These side chicks got to stop. They got to stop or be stopped. They don't know their place no more. Let me see now. Let me carry on. I miss him so much. He's been gone for several months now and refused to accept my calls or emails. Cause he know you crazy. He told me to leave him alone. Cause he know you crazy. that we did what we did was a mistake. He and his wife are going to counseling to work on their marriage, and he is happier than he has ever been. I don't believe this.
Crazy.
He's only saying this because his wife put him up to it. He told me he was going to leave me, his wife, for me. I just want to make that happen. He's mine. See?
Crazy.
How could he say he never loved me and we were a mistake?
That's what you are when you're a damn jump off. You're a mistake. You are an accident. You ain't something that's meant to be, bruh. You're just something that just happened. You're just something that happened. That's all. Get that shit through your head, honey. You ain't... Girl, bye-bye.
I just want to make that happen. How could he say he loved me? He never loved me and we were a mistake. He not my man.
Crazy.
He would never say that. My question is, how should I use voodoo to get my man back from that crazy lady who took him away? I love him and I miss him. Signed, Angry Mistress. Girl, if you don't sit yourself down somewhere, that man is not yours. That man is not yours. I'm sorry. That's the married lady's man. And you are crazy. Let it go, boo. Let it go. I don't know what else to say to you, but let it go. It's not gonna work. You fuck around and do some voodoo, and the voodoo turn into hoodoo, and it be on you. You be walking around here like a crazy... Well, no. It might work and change you. You might not be crazy no more. I don't... But y'all heard it. That's just crazy. Now, maybe tomorrow I do part two of Ricky Smiley and do my Steve tomorrow evening like I'm doing now. But yeah, this is your girl, Miss Benjamin Buttons 01. Like, comment, subscribe, share. I'm out.